Now in other news, the head of the International Labor Organization is in the Philippines to extend his sympathies and help the survivors of Typhoon Pablo. Niña Corpuz has this exclusive.
Losing loved ones and homes in a disaster is tragic, and to lose one's source of income makes it even worse. The International Labor Organization, or ILO, reports an estimated 2.3 million workers have been directly affected by Typhoon Pablo in Mindanao. They are mostly women aged 15 to 24 and vulnerable family workers like farmers, fisherfolk, or street vendors. Majority of them are from the Davao region. This is what greeted ILO Director General Guy Ryder on his visit to the Philippines. Ryder said the ILO has set aside initial funding of $50,000 or 2 million pesos to jumpstart a livelihood program in partnership with the government.
We try to help in the reconstruction process through infrastructure and also local economic development processes to get communities together, to give them a new livelihood prospect.
Ryder's visit is also anxiously looking at the president signing into law the Domestic Workers or Kasambahay Bill, which was ratified by Congress after 15 years. Ryder hopes the bill will finally recognize this workforce he described as invisible.
The problem is really this consciousness. People somehow think that because these people work in private homes, they're not part of public policy. Well, they have to be covered by public policy.
Meanwhile, Ryder said the country's GDP economic growth, which was 7.1% in this year's third quarter, was respectable. But he also agreed with the notion that it's a jobless growth not felt by ordinary workers. While the poor may have work, they remain poor.
And I think what really matters is not simply the numbers of jobs created. The quality of jobs created matters a lot as well.
This reality is even more apparent as Christmas approaches. Children flock the streets begging and working to augment the family's income. In a 2012 survey by the NSO, 5.5 million children aged 5 to 17 years old are working.
I think child labor should remain a priority all of the time, and the ILO works very hard to make sure that child workers are not forgotten.
But despite the challenges the country is facing, Ryder praised the Filipinos.
I think the biggest potential of the Philippines is its people, not only here in the Philippines, but wherever I've lived, I've always met Filipinos, working, contributing to society's progress, and I think that dynamism is your best asset.
Ryder's visit to the Philippines is his first since being elected ILO Director General. The last visit of ILO's highest official to the country was 17 years ago in 1995. Niña Corpuz, ABS-CBN News.